Speak Low, you probably heard this. It's a jazz standard. It was from a musical, One Touch of Venus, that Kurt Weill wrote with the poet Ogden Nash, wrote the lyrics. What I find unusual about Kurt Weill, he was very popular in the 20s in Germany when he wrote the Three Penny Opera, which has, everybody knows Mack the Knife because that was made into a big hit in the 50s, actually. Dun, 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 dun. But his harmonic style and rhythmic use of rhythm was emulated by Candor and Ebb in Cabaret, a lot of the songs in Cabaret. And actually, the woman who played the landlady was Lotta Lenya, who had been in the much, in the 20s, like 40 years earlier, had been in his productions and I think was married to him even. And the song will, For the Sun Will Rise and the Moon Will Set, the in Cabaret, that's very similar harmonies to what you hear in Kurt Weill. I did a Kurt Weill song another time in this seminar, What Good Would the Moon Be? And I pointed out how, because he was German and emigrated to this country, he didn't really get the accents of American speech. And I in a way I fault the poet in this as well, because I don't think he had experience as a songwriter that I know of. I mean, he was more known as a poet than a songwriter. But the words are speak low when you speak, comma, love, which implies to me that he's trying to say, speak low when you speak love, like calling the person love. But when you sing it the way he said it rhythmically, it sounds like it doesn't have the comma, like you're saying, speak low when you speak love, when you speak about love. So, I could find fault with whatever, but that's what I thought it always meant until I noticed the comma in the words. So that's about it. And another thing is the A section, it's almost like it has four A sections, because first it does it in one key, then it does it in another key, then it goes back and does it the first key, then the second, then the B section finally comes. But it's a good as a jazz standard. Wait a sec. It's good as a jazz standard because of the harmonies and the intervals that is very striking and unusual, that sounds very much like Kurt Weill only. Speak low.
Time is so old and
is pretty. I mean, you can't fault his music. It is very original. You don't have anybody else writing with these unusual chords. Another song you probably know from popular culture because The Doors put it on their first or second album. Oh, show me the way to the next whiskey bar. Oh, don't ask why. That's from, I don't think that's not from Three Penny Opera. I think that's from Mahogany. Oh, moon of Alabama, now I say goodbye. So he has this really unusual sort of cynical harmonic language.